Hello, everybody. I am the Marshal, and today we will be continuing Life is Strange. This game is going good so far, so I hope you enjoyed Episode 1, Save Game 2. So continue.
In the previous episodes of Life is Strange.
They call film Little Pieces of Time.
Because Max wants everybody to see
I'm
how
so sick of people trying to control me!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
And there she is. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories.
Let's talk about your superpower.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please, step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
Please, get me out of here!
Nobody cares about me. Nobody. What are you doing here, Max?
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the route with Kate Marsh? Please, tell us everything.
What the hell is this?
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today.
I believe you, Warren. I'll believe anything this week.
I can't remember the name of this song, or not just yet anyway.
Kate!
It's probably one of the ones without lyrics. I don't know the names of those ones. Get that ass in
new
gear
clothes
now.
Be all over this. So I better get moving.
Okay. Here's how long the episodes were last time. I'm not sure I'm going to do as much exploring and looking around as I used to.
No way can I clean that shit off. Time to get Samuel da Vinci to repaint. Jeebus, I am so freaking tired. I sound like a moron. But crime does not delay. I need to stay on top of this
investigation.
Kate's okay, Max. Take a breath. Get your shit together. You have time.
Yep. Beers, if you remember from the last video, I did manage to save Kate, which was something I was worried that I wasn't going to be able to do.
Okay, this is scary dark. Let there be...
flashlight. Like a horror game. Oops. Stop it. Didn't mean to do that. I guess we'll talk.
Hey, Dana. How are you doing?
Better than Kate. I just can't believe she would even attempt suicide.
We're all responsible. Blame Victoria. She was depressed.
I think we're all responsible for what happened.
True. But you're the only one who went up to that roof with Kate.
That was bullshit. Where was everybody else?
I know. You're a better person than any of us here. Hey, Max. I think I need to crash now. I'm just over everything today.
Okay. Thoughtful things. Waiting for you, Kate.
Dana's really hurting over this.
Before you, Kate. Waiting for you, Kate. I said that I wasn't going to look at many, but...
do they really need that crap on the door? Kate's still alive. So much hypocrite.
Yep. So let's go. Left. Left mouth. Can't speak. Left mouse button to left.
So Chloe is waiting for me in front of the main hall.
Ah, gotcha.
Principal Wells. Oh, are you serious? I'm toast if he sees me.
I know, I have a set of keys on me. Somewhere. Ah. Gotcha.
Max the Ninja strikes again.
Sit my ass down.
So, let's see what Chloe wants.
Get it? Booyah. Like I'm a scary punk ghost.
More like a scary punk asshole. Hey, Chloe, I didn't exactly have the greatest day trying to keep my friend from jumping off the roof. I don't think I need you to prank me tonight, okay?
Sorry, but you absolutely balls to the walls did save your friend.
Kate saved herself. I couldn't even use my power. My head felt like it was being crushed. Then I had no clue what to say to her on that roof.
Don't be so modest, Rockstar. Kate is alive because of you. You obviously said the right thing, and your badass power is gonna save us all. We just need to connect the plays.
And find out who almost killed Kate. We have to stop this from happening to anybody else.
Oh yeah, and somehow stop that tornado from wiping out Arcadia Bay, right?
I hope so, Chloe. But how? Snow and eclipse are bad omens.
This whole town is a bad omen. And notice that Blackwell seems to be ground zero.
Chloe, I just feel weird about some of my decisions. Especially after I just got Nathan expelled.
Dude, do not even torture yourself like that. Let's focus on looking for clues, okay?
Right. For one thing, there's too much coincidence between the people around Kate and Rachel.
Like Step Prick and Nathan Prescott?
Not just them.
Yep. I just want to beat the shit out of those particular bros.
And even though I don't know her, it feels like Rachel is guiding us to the truth.
Fuck the truth. I just want to find my friend right now. It scares me to think where she could be. Do you think she's...
alive? I have to think that, Chloe. Her spirit is so powerful here.
Maybe too much power. Max, we have to find Rachel soon. We have to.
I promise you we will. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues. Now tell me, what's your secret?
Drumroll, please. I present the spare keys to Blackwell. Thank you, Step Prick.
You are such a boss, Chloe. I just don't want you to get into any more trouble.
Look at all the trouble dropping in Arcadia Bay. At this point, who gives a fuck anymore? We're in it to win it, Max. Lead the way.
I'm so glad you're my partner in crime.
As long as you're my partner in time.
Insert groan here.
If Chloe's a boss, then does that mean she's related to Jacksepticeye?
Thank you again so much for helping me put together a portfolio.
Hopefully the rest of the class will follow your lead. I'm sorry I was distracted. As you know, it's not been a good day for Blackwell.
I know this has been an awful day, and you can talk to me anytime, Mr. Jefferson.
Thank you, Victoria. I'm glad it had a relatively happy ending.
I don't know what I would have done if Katie jumped.
Katie? I had no idea you two were that close. Did she?
Well, how does this affect the Everyday Heroes contest?
It doesn't. The contest is still a go, and I still have to pick the winner to best represent Blackwell. I've got all the photos, except one from Max.
I'll give you a one-word sneak preview of Max's photo. Selfie. Listen, you've seen my entry. You know it's better than that. Wouldn't that be so cool to hang out together in San Francisco, Mark?
Stick to Mr. Jefferson, Victoria, please. And, I haven't picked a winner yet.
You already love my work, so it's not like you're playing favorites. Just imagine if you picked my photo, though. We would have to spend a lot of time together. That could be fun, don't you think?
I'm going to think that you didn't say any of that.
You might as well choose me. Otherwise, I might have to tell people you offered to choose my photo for favors or something.
As a favor to your future, I'll also ignore that undisguised threat. This conversation is officially over, Miss Chase. I suggest you go back to your dorm now.
Wait! I only... Are you fucking kidding me? So stupid.
Just when I think Victoria can't get any more evil. Shit is about to get real at Blackwell. Let's go find out. Chloe the Keymaster. You know it. Dude, I don't know about this. We're both already in so much trouble.
Not to mention the weed you brought into my room. Joking.
I'm serious. We're not kids anymore. We're breaking and entering.
If I have a key, how can it be breaking? I get charges for just entering.
I'm serious. We could go to jail.
Not if I'm related to the head of Blackwell Security. Step shit will not want me in the hands of the local police. So we better find out what's in the principal's office first. You can rewind if we get caught, right? You have mad powers, Max.
But my powers didn't save Kate. Maybe I did on my own.
Come on, one more door and our work here is done.
Too bad you can't run.
That's it. officer should have the key to the principal's office.
He's hiding shit, like everybody here.
Well, now we definitely have to get this door open. Believe it or not, I know a little about lockpicking, thanks to Frank. I might as well test out my thief skill.
Go for it. We're already in this deep.
Well, you could look for the key, just in case.
Why, yes, I could.
Have something to show you when my friends can, yeah. I forgot, how do you? Thanks for letting me gush over our Blackwell hero. I miss your voice. We're very proud to milk this. We're so proud to milk this moment. Let us know if you want to come up for a quick getaway, okay? We love you, Maxine. Warren. Thanks, Warren. I need to risk my cape tonight, Nathan's. So it's a good day. I'll call you later, okay? Okay, I guess I can't just call them. Call them. Not yet, anyways.
Here are the keys. None for the principal's office. Desolation. Nothing to see here.
Okay. So.
Nothing here.
Other drawer.
Dead end. No key for thee. We have to find another way in.
Guess I didn't spend enough time with Frank, but I'll use my DIY lockpick tools while you come up with a better plan.
My plan has a name.
Now we call.
Hey, Warren, you busy? Just bubble hearth, you'll be okay. Listen, I need your physics expertise stat. Without naming names, if somebody had access to the art and science labs and wanted to construct a device that would, say, open a locked door, would you maybe kind of know how? Huh? No, I'm just asking for fun. Thanks, science guy. No, stay. We need you as backup. Just send the text instructions now. Yes, I'm still all in to go ape with you at the drive-in. Thanks for the help.
This sucks ass. Goddamn door. Try not to wake up everybody at Blackwell. Sorry, Max. I got nothing. What about your plan?
I'm gonna go put it together. Can you stay here and not get caught?
I might get on the other side of that door before you, Lupin.
The race is on. See you soon.
We're gonna make a bomb.
Warren is such a classic nerd. Let's see if I can find those items.
Let's blow that door.
Release the Kraken.
Take?
It's all mine anyway. Only three more items to go.
Okay, so now, science class.
Gross, I hate that formalin smell.
Formalin?
An A minus? All right. So Dr. Max did help Warren this morning.
Sugar.
You're halfway home, Max.
I'm guessing there's two more now?
I never said they were great, troll.
an artist, David, not a scientist. But this is so not sodium chlorate.
Oh yeah, that one.
Here's the sodium chlorate box. Ew, gross. At least switch to e-cigs.
I guess, so reaching up there, we need something to stand on? Maybe?
So, sodium chlorate is a weed killer. You'd think Warren would have told me that factoid.
Okay. So let's get this. You know. Oh, hey.
You know you're clumsy, Max. Don't waste your rewind power. Use the damn chair.
Anyways. Yeah.
Only just one more ingredient left.
Don't make bombs, especially not in school. That won't end well for you. Next one will be the art room. Art class. One last ingredient.
This is like a scene in a horror film.
Or horror game.
Even when you were sad, you tried to see the good in the world. Shit. Daniel's a better illustrator than photographer, said Max, the art critic. Victoria, that is pretty fucking sweet. How can I hate somebody that shoots like that?
Easily.
Victoria's cigarettes? I'm sure Mr. Jefferson is impressed.
And there it is, duct tape. The final ingredient.
The tape is mine. Now it's time to show Chloe that Max is the bomb.
Yep. Doors blow, so we're gonna have a blast. Photo. Let's go find the principal's office. There's the exit. Bathroom. Okay, I forgot where the principal's office was. Sorry about that. Office is science, art, Kate's locker.
So glad you still have your locker, Kate.
Here we go, I think. Unless I'm going into the wrong room again. And I went into the wrong room. No, wait, again, I actually didn't go into the wrong room the first time, so. Went into the wrong room for the first time. Okay, so seriously, where is the principal's office? with directions. If that wasn't obvious. Oh, the door was open. Well, fuck.
Take it easy on the door, Chloe. Let's try this instead. Boom! Literally.
Yes! Time to blow shit up!
If you'll light the candle.
This is so cool!
Get ready to haul ass.
Where did we get the fuse? The fuse wasn't on the list of things to get.
That was so fucking cool! Oh, we are toast! Here comes the whole Arcadia Bay Fire and Police Department. So what should we do?
Don't worry, I have a plan. I have a plan! Where do you fast forward this? Here you go.
Open, she can't cheat with her rewind. Oh, this is bullshit. Fucking door.
That's probably not a good idea. Don't fuck
doors. You are magic. I have no clue how the hell you got in there, but you did it, sister.
The company I keep. Now, let's find what we want and beat it. My powers only go so far.
Man, I can see why the principal locks this room up. Fancy faux art crap. He must want everybody to know he has money, but no taste. How can you trust somebody who has a fucking bronze bird in his office? I'm glad I was expelled.
Yes, if only the principal had a Monet or Picasso, you'd still be at Blackwell.
Eat me. I'm gonna pilfer the papers on this ugly-ass desk.
Yep. And now we search for evidence.
Okay, sure. It's ugly, but damn, is it a cozy chair. This is your chance to truly get all deductive and shit, Sherlock. Find us some clues about Rachel, or Kate, or Nathan. Anybody. I'm on the case.
Okay.
Tumbleweeds.
Oops, wrong one. Let's talk to... Keep your smart mouth shut about everything, or I'm coming for your ass. I know where you sleep. Hey, whore. Feminazis will be exterminated. Watch out. Oh, feminazi. And then keep on forgetting what the back one is. There we go. Oh, so it wasn't Warren. No, it was Warren. So did you blow the lock? Unabomber? Okay.
Tumbleweeds.
Oh. So there's nothing there.
Weird. This asshole has a spotless record.
Student information sheet. Nathan Joshua Prescott. GPA 3.7. Brief summary. Nathan Prescott continues his family's historical legacy at Blackwell Academy with a stellar academic record and a variety of extracurricular activities, including work with the Arcadia Bay Homeless Fund. Nathan is also popular with students and faculty. He stands as a proud representation of Blackwell.
Like I'm not gonna read my own personal file.
Student information sheet. Maxwell Caulfield, GPA 2.8. Brief summary. Max, as she prefers to be called, is considered a quiet, attentive student with much potential for her photography. Her GPA fluctuates, and she has acknowledged she should be doing better. Her teachers back up her quiet intelligence, though some complaints find her too nervous and nosy. Some facility members would like Max to speak up more in class and be more assertive. Others would like her to be less so, but this is a common student suggestion rather than a specific recommendation. Update: despite some recent information with Blackwell Security, Max showed herself to represent the very best of Blackwell Academy by stopping fellow student Kate Marsh from jumping off the dormitory roof today. At this time, there is an ongoing police facility investigation, but Max's heroism is undisputed.
This file is going to be so spotless, I'll projectile vomit.
Student information sheet, Victoria Maribeth Chase, GPA 3.9. Brief summary, Victoria Chase is the gold standard for Blackwell Academy, a student with a consistently high GPA and extracurricular activities that reflect her career goals in photography. Victoria also receives high marks for faculty for her devotion to the Vortex Club, among other organizations devoted to Blackwell's spirit and history.
I have to make sure Warren doesn't have a criminal background.
She likes him. That's why she's checking this out. Student information sheet, Warren Graham, GPA 4.0. Brief summary, Warren is considered an exemplary student and represents a long tradition of excellence in science at Blackwell. He has the gift or curse of gab, depending on the faculty. Some have accused him of playing science pranks, but this is not confirmed by his science teacher, Miss Grant. We hope Warren focuses his academic vision and continues towards his bright future.
Only two more files to go. Rachel doesn't seem so troubled based on all this. But there's not much here about the police investigation.
Student information sheet. Rachel Dawn Amber. Unfortunately, Rachel Amber has stopped attending class for the past month, and she's left no contact with students or faculty for the past month. Her parents are at the present unaware of her whereabouts, and Blackwell hopes for her quick return to continue her academic excellence. Brief summary, Rachel Amber is the quintessential student representation of Blackwell Academy. She excels in all of her studies and extracurricular activities, which are numerous. Popular with both students and faculty, she has the de facto qualities of scholarship and leadership that is a hallmark of Blackwell's legacy. Her diverse goals include a career in international law and fashion modeling. There is no doubt that Rachel will achieve all of her dreams with Blackwell as the fulcrum. Principal Wells, this is Lieutenant Chris Rossi. Just wanted to let you know that Rachel Amber's investigation has officially been closed on our end. We always hope for that one magic clue, but once again Arcadia Bay covers up another secret. We always keep our eyes and ears open, but that's all we can do for now. Thanks for all your help. Lieutenant Chris Rossi, Arcadia Bay PD.
Man, I don't blame the principal for expelling Chloe. Bad Chloe.
Chloe is Elizabeth Price, GPA 1.7. Brief summary, Chloe Price is a problematic student at Blackwell despite the best efforts of the faculty and administration to guide her academically. Chloe does little homework and is often willfully belligerent to her teachers. She has caused numerous class disruptions and inappropriate comments and rude gestures to fellow students. She was recently suspended for spray painting graffiti in the parking lot. Even though Chloe is an intelligent student with potential, she chooses to squander it on empty rebellion against the non-mandatory institution. Chloe Price is no longer a student at Blackwell. See attached police report. Chloe was no longer a student at Blackwell.
Let's nab this last file, Sherlock. Always wanted to say nab.
Search.
And nothing here. I'd drink too if I was the principal of Blackwell.
That also explains why he's such a shitty principal.
Wowzer, this will so not come in handy.
It would be easier if I could actually see. Oh, lamp.
This pretty much sums up Kate. Shy and sweet. And in the wrong place.
Student information sheet. Kate Beverly Marsh, GPA 3.9. Kate Marsh represents the very best of the students at Blackwell Academy. Her GPA is consistently outstanding, along with her optimistic attitude and quiet work ethic. Her extracurricular activities with the Meals on Wheels program has been acknowledged by 7 News, and her diverse religious studies group has been a welcome addition to the wide range of student-led spiritual programs at Blackwell. She also has one of the best attendance records in the school's history. As the school's nurse, I should inform you that Kate Marsh appears to have experienced some recent emotional or physical trauma. I spoke to her briefly, and she was upset but vague and refused to talk further with me. I think it's important that we keep our eyes on her and make sure she does not under duress during other classmates, as is my suspicion. Regards, and Mary Brunsey. At present time, there is a security investigation into a controversial video allegedly featuring Kate Marsh at a Vortex Club party that has been uploaded into the internet without her knowledge or alleged consent. Along with her claim of being taken to the hospital during the party, see the attached files for complete details.
I think we found everything in here. I should go join Chloe now.
Should probably turn that off, so they don't know we were here.
Max, you better come check out these files. Nathan accuses Rachel of bringing drugs on campus, and my step troll went along because he thinks Rachel was a bad influence on me. Assholes.
If David is teaming up with Nathan Prescott, that's a bad sign.
Nathan Prescott III. Ooh, he's so money. And you know the Prescotts dropped Major Bank to bury Nathan's real file. Look, it reads like a rap sheet. Bad grades, teacher complaints, secret probation. But I was expelled?
At least Nathan was finally suspended. Check out that note. Open it.
It's just some crazy drawing.
It's not a drawing. Look. Rachel in the dark room. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
That's fucked up. What does this even mean? Nathan is truly psychotic. I know he has something to do with Rachel missing.
Whoa, listen to this. David M. always asks what's going on in my head. David M. always helps me follow those he follows. It's pretty cryptic.
No, it sounds like they formed some sort of weird team, the Super Hebros.
Jesus,
David was stalking Kate, hassling me, and now we know he was all over Rachel, too. Oh, we are so going into his garage files. Plus, I'm getting a little paranoid in here. We got our info. Let's bail. But maybe we shouldn't leave without a gift. No, you are not taking the cozy chair. Max, do your powers include mind reading? Or did you just rewind because I tried to steal the chair? Shit, I'm confused. It's the powers of best friendship. I know how you roll. We should definitely get out of here. We pressed our luck enough. Hello, what have we here? Holy shit! Jackpot! Cha-ching! Wow, sir. That's a lot for the handicapped fund. Dude, there's $5,000 here. I could pay Frank back tonight. This'll chill him out after our knife showdown yesterday. Are you gonna make a big issue out of this? Or just rewind and take the greenbacks for yourself? I hope you do that instead of lecturing me.
I am not stealing from the handicap fund. That's evil.
You really want to take money from the handicapped fund? I know you need to pay Frank back, but I've got my power to protect you, right? There's a lot of power in that horse-choking wad of cash. But yes, Moral Max is right again. I guess. Let's get the hell out of this office morgue. I know that money would have helped Chloe and me.
But now, let us go.
That impish look scares me. Care for a midnight swim? The Blackwell pool is ours. Swimming? You want to take that risk now? It's been a cray week. You didn't let me take that money to pay off Frank, so if he pops a cap in my skull, at least allow me to have a little carefree fun for a few minutes. Splish splash? You're right. We hella deserve it. Splish splash. Did you actually just say hella? I think I'm a good bad influence on you. We're in the otter's lair. Big fucking deal. I want that heated water. We still have to play it cool, okay? I still go to school here. You can own this hellhole once you figure out your rewind power. Chloe is so psyched for girls' night out, so I better follow her evil plan. Boys or girls?
Let's be daring.
Boys, of course.
Figures. Perv.
Let me check to see if the pool's heated.
Okay, so let's go. Through the door. This door.
I guess somebody forgot their Blackwell spirit.
Or just their jacket.
I guess I should consider this evolution.
Donna, I know I'm an asshole. I'm a... what? Oh, a-hole. But I still care about you. Love, Logan.
Boys' locker room is right. Sometimes.
No worries, it's all bad.
Huh, it's nice to know Victoria loves something besides herself. I bet you do.
My heart, Warren Garen. Okay, enough looking at graffiti. Let's get to the pool.
Bros will be bros.
69 reasons to bang Rachel. Oh, something you might not have known. I had a sister named Rachel. She was one of my three sisters, but the only one of them that was older than me. And, related by DNA rather than adoption.
Max, try to find the light for the pool. I want to see the sharks.
Otters don't like sharks. They bite.
So do I. Hit that light.
Light it up. Wrong door. Oxygen kit.
In case I run out of air, I know where to come. There has to be a control panel for the lights around here.
Dummy. Coffee?
Coffee and swimming. Good combo.
Is it not? Oh, yeah, over here. I like the effects on the walls. Also, Chloe changes fast. She changes hella fast.
Time to do or dive, Max.
Oh yeah, baby, it feels like a hot tub. Too bad you made me feel like the queen of assholes because I wanted that cash stash. Tell me you're not gonna stand there watching me like a zombie. Don't you dare! Come stop me, hippie. Okay, you asked for it.
Why is your necklace attached to her and not floating about?
Cowabunga! Why, look, an otter in my water. Dun, 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 dun. You are so obvious. And I still get freaked out by that movie, so stop. I can't even watch any of those shark shows. I'll just rewind and harpoon you. Otter's revenge.
Cheater.
Yeah, you wouldn't know about that. I wish Rachel was here. She would totally love being in here at night. Wish you guys had met each other.
We will. With all this stuff going on, I'm starting to think everything is related.
And I want to find out for Kate's sake. She almost died today.
Your power is changing everything, Max. Especially you. I can already tell.
You're not so chicken shit anymore.
Thanks, girlfriend. You know what I mean. You're becoming like this force of nature.
More like luck of nature. Come on, my power failed trying to rescue Kate. Maybe I'm just stumbling back and forth in time. For what reason?
You didn't stumble when you saved me, Max.
Not that time. But that's because you were there to kickstart my power.
So it's time to start moving forward in time. And we're obviously connected, since without me, you would have never discovered your power, right?
Absolutely. You make me feel like I know what I'm doing.
And you make me feel like I have a reason for still being in Arcadia Bay.
I hope so.
Stop being so goddamn humble. You're like the smartest, most talented person I've ever known.
More than Rachel Amber?
Dude, I'm not her groupie, okay? And I'm sure you have Blackwell bros all over you. Like Warren.
You're the bro killer. Tats and two.
You did not just say that. Plus, I am not down with these Arcadia Bay hillbillies.
I don't blame you. Anyway, we have bigger fish to fry, right?
No worries. Once you get over yourself, you're gonna make the world bow.
As long as you're there with me.
Don't look so sad. I'm never leaving you.
Now I'm getting cold in here.
Because we're yapping instead of attacking each other, otter versus shark style. I think I've had my pool experience for the year. Let's check.
Let's call it a draw. I'm gonna freeze my ass off when I get out. Gross. I feel like we just went swimming in Chlorine Bay.
You look cute with your hair soaked in chemicals.
Thanks. You would know.
Hi!
Oh no, security! Let me guess. It's Mike, the security guard.
We have to go now!
A hiding spot, or both.
Where are they?
Hello? I know the secret to escaping him. Why can't I? Oh, bench. Son of a bench! Wouldn't that be like a chair or couch? Would it have to be smaller than a bench? They're like a leaning chair.
Better not try any Halloween pranks after today. I'm serious. I heard something over here. Who's here? I got a flashlight and a stick.
I got a flashlight and a stick. Beware. Gone. So let's sneak back through here. So we can be home for not here. So we can be home free. Back to the pool. Back to the pool.
We are so invisible.
Let's bail.
Wait, turn around. They're coming. We have to find another way out.
Oh, this is bullshit.
You can't go back to your dorm now. You're a Blackwell fugitive. Crash at my place tonight. You want me to crash where the Blackwell security officer lives so I'll be safe? Okay. Into the car. Get in.
Later, fuckers. Max, you rock. We are so fucking awesome.
Yes, we so are.
It doesn't matter if I don't swear, because that would have made it so I couldn't monetize this video anyways. Not that I monetize my videos anyways. It's all not monetized all the time. I make absolutely no money. bedroom selfie.
Always remember this moment.
Photobomb!
Photo hog. It feels like a different world from yesterday.
We left a skid mark on Blackwell last night.
Like it needs another one. I'd like to do something good for my school in Arcadia Bay. I can't even submit my photo to represent. I just don't want to be rejected.
Every great artist gets rejected before they get accepted. So you have to enter a photo.
Even though I'm pimping the school and town you want to torch?
Come on, I don't want to see Arcadia Bay burn to the shore. I just say shit like that because I've been trying to get out of here since... since you left, basically. If I could find Rachel, then pay Frank off. I'm still leaving to start a whole new life.
Wish we could just hang out all morning like we used to. Maybe we should get up. I have to get back to Blackwell soon.
Oh, does the schoolgirl have a test today?
I'm starting to feel like going to Blackwell every day is a test. I just need to get on my regular school schedule again.
This song is called Lua.
Keep waving at the taxis, they keep turning their lights off.
Okay, I need to get dressed now.
Julie knows a
party. I don't think I'll be moshing today.
Supplies are endless in the evening.
Man, if I had stayed hidden, David wouldn't be targeting me. I thought Chloe might put up a pic of me instead. Can't compete with Rachel. Holy shitballs. Frank is scary. I should have let Chloe take that money. Ugh. Still reeks like a chlorine factory.
See if you can find a suitable outfit in my fashion hole.
Yep. No.
Okay. Time for some Chloe cosplay.
Hey, there you go. Rachel left a bunch of her clothes with me. She's your size.
But not quite my style.
Max, you don't have a style yet. At least give it a try. You can always rewind back to your chlorine brand t-shirt and generic jeans.
You suck. I like my shirt and jeans. But it would be cool to try on Rachel's clothes just to see if they fit.
Stop second-guessing yourself, Max. Put this on and let your inner punk rock girl come out. You can afford to take chances whenever and whatever you want to try. For example, I dare you to kiss me.
What?
I double dare you. Kiss me now.
No doubt about it.
Damn. You're hardcore, Max. Now I can text Warren and tell him he doesn't stand a chance. Unless he's into girl-on-girl action.
You're such a dork. Oh man, that was priceless when I kissed Chloe. She didn't think I would.
I wasn't going to pass up that opportunity.
Looking sick, Max. A couple tats, some piercings, and we'll make a thrasher out of you yet.
Ready for the mosh pit, Shaka Bra?
Maybe not. Go on down and say hi to Joyce. Free breakfast. I have to wake and bake first.
I promise not to tell.
Let's not rewind and find out, okay?
Okay. So, let's go!
Oh my god, that smells so amazing. It's like when we were kids here.
Oh, Kate. Let's read real quick. Thank you so much for talking to me this morning. I was about to have a serious cry and I needed a friend. You were there as usual. Max, thank you from my heart for reaching out to me on the roof. You're the only one who was there for me at school, the only one who truly cared. I have to believe you were sent to give me hope. You did so much more than that. My father is grateful as well. You'll always be in our prayers, love, and blessings. Your friend, Kate. Hey, Kate, I'm so glad you're okay. I will visit you as soon as I can, promise.
Good morning, Joyce.
Rachel! Max. Who? You startled me. Well, you fit those clothes well. Thank God you're not a hellraiser like her or Chloe. Now tell me exactly what you want to chow on.
Pancakes, eggs, and bacon. Tough one. Generic breakfast.
Eggs and bacon all the way.
Remember when you guys would sleep in until I yelled out, wakey, wakey, eggs and bacon?
Totally. We'd wake up so fast.
So this time you can help me with the ingredients. I need you to grab me the actual eggs and the bacon.
I can handle eggs and bacon. The eggs always come first, as Joyce used to say. I should evolve and become a vegan, but bacon.
Technically, you'd also have to give up eggs if you're going to become a vegan.
Thanks. After all these years and everything that's happened, it's great to see you and Chloe together again. She hasn't had a good friend since you or Rachel. Oh, those clothes remind me so much of her. Such a sweet girl. I'm just hoping she's living large in L.A.
I'd love to think that too, Joyce, but...
We are on the same page, Max. I keep hoping that Rachel will show up or even send a message to Chloe from Hollywood. Or wherever she is.
I hate to even think this, much less say it out loud, but I think Rachel is in serious trouble.
I know. I watch those awful true crime shows, and it makes me ill if I think about Rachel ending up on one. So I don't think too much.
I see why Chloe is so obsessed with finding her.
Max Caulfield, are you actually jealous of Rachel?
Maybe. Rachel was so much cooler than me.
You think? Then why has Chloe been telling me she wishes she could be more like you over the past 5 years?
Doubt it. Did she really? 5 years ago feels like 1,000 now.
And that makes me, what, a century old? You're only 18, Max. Oh, youth. If only I could go back.
It's not all that, Joyce.
Voila, a breakfast fit for us queens. And a king. Go sit at the table.
I kind of want eggs and bacon now.
Thank you so much, Joyce. I'm never leaving this table.
Good, you can clean.
Even though it's 8:27 p.m. here while I'm recording, eggs and bacon is always good. Peanut butter. Look at that.
I guess nobody waters the plant here.
Look at the peanut butter.
I'm glad that's creamy and
seeing you again. Made me remember so much. I know these photos don't measure up to your work, Max.
My favorite photographers probably take pictures similar to yours. You make David happy, Joyce.
He wants us all to be happy, Max. He's just not great at showing it.
I don't think I can rock this outfit like Rachel.
You have your own cool style.
Wowzer. I totally remember that day.
I'm glad. William took this picture with his instant camera. Oh, it was the last picture he ever took. He had his car out right after this, and...
I know, Joyce. I'm sorry.
I didn't show you this to be morbid. In fact, I want you to have this. This was when my baby was so full of life and light. She was hopeful, positive, and everything she's not today. And this was the last time I ever saw Chloe truly happy.
Did you guys have a bonding session about how fucked up I am?
It's not always about you.
Chloe, please. It's too early to start picking a fight. Eat instead.
I'll keep the warden busy while you go peek in the garage.
Now stop whispering, or I'll know you're talking about me.
Stop being so nosy, Mother. Jeez, I can't do anything around here without everybody getting up in my shit.
Oh, no one can even joke with you, Chloe. You fly off the handle like that.
Excuse me, I have to use the bathroom.
Sure, run off and pee when you should back me up.
Now who's being paranoid? Just listen to yourself.
Nobody else does.
I do need to get into David's computer. He's gotta be hiding shit.
Guns. And, looks sort of like a cross. But what would he need a cross for? Unless he's a vampire hunter. Dun dun dun. No. Alright, I can't look for the password until after I turn on the laptop. Use.
No shit, it needs a password. How about step douche? Try again. I need more clues.
Of course it's not going to be that. Doy. Son.
Joyce might as well have wrote, "Let's get married." That might be a useful password.
Diner. Yeah, whatever.
Now the car looks ready to roll. This is a better hobby for David than surveillance.
And there. Now he doesn't know that I searched there.
Cute. Can't picture David driving Joyce around with this on the car. Maybe I could try stepdad for the password.
There you go. Leave no evidence.
Nothing to see here. Max the hacker strikes again. Whoa, spoiler alert. Rachel definitely hooked up with Frank. But why does David care? Instead of stalking Kate, David could have helped her.
Kate M follows same path to every class. Overheard Kate and Donna W talking about supplies for Vortex Club party. Drugs. Watched Kate with her crutch group. She knows her Bible. Kate stays in bathroom longer than other students. Drugs. saw Kate helping Jefferson after class. Don't trust grown men with goatees. Kate was kept to herself since Vortex Club party, not even church drugs. Tried to talk to Kate about the party. She got upset and ran. Guilty.
This is so wrong. Oh, creepy bastard.
Max Online Analysis. Mad Max, Max Factor, Noir Angel. Maxine Caulfield, student. Well then, Max's class schedule, October week 2 schedule.
I better tell Chloe about this now. It's just one more thing to make her sad and mad.
No, it was this one. So did we already see the cat missing up here then?
Chloe can't get another gun now. Unless she steals it back from Frank.
I guess. Oops. Let's turn off the laptop. Okay, getting rid of all this evidence probably doesn't really matter. Really? So wait, do I already know about that? Apparently, I guess.
Nice breakfast.
David, you back already?
I have to take a nap after writing up vandalism reports last night.
What happened?
Some little shit-ass punks broke into the swimming pool. This is what happens at these PC bullshit colleges. Entitled students taking over the campus.
Do you know for sure it was Blackwell students?
Who else would do it? And I'm gonna bust them. Figures you'd be here. Is that your Rachel Amber Halloween costume?
You know more about her than me.
No, you and Chloe think you know more than anybody, like all teenagers.
Leave Max alone, David. Stop threatening students.
He threatens them with surveillance cameras so he can spy on everybody, like he spies on all of us here.
Don't start, Chloe. Not now.
Yeah, I'm just always starting shit, right? You're a total paranoid, David.
Not now, Chloe.
He used to call me a loser for getting kicked out of Blackwell. So who's the loser now, David? Who haven't you accused or harassed? Between your investigations into Rachel and Kate, what have you done besides get in trouble?
I'm gonna side with Chloe, of course.
You're a bully, David. I saw you harass Kate Marsh when she was going through hell.
You could have totally helped her. Everybody at Blackwell is a suspect to you, except for Nathan Prescott. That's why the students and faculty don't like you. You even threatened me. I do respect your service, but you don't respect anybody.
You were smoking pot in Chloe's room. That's illegal.
So is spying on people in your family and at your work. Why do you have photos of Kate Marsh and Rachel Amber in your files anyway?
What? Is this true, Max?
Yes, David. Why do you have these files at all? I find this very disturbing.
I do not have to take this kind of interrogation. Not from you punks.
Maybe you should calm down.
Oh, you're turning on me now, huh? Of course, women always stick together.
That's sexist.
Well, screw you.
David, you better go to a hotel until we figure this out.
You can't kick me out of my own home.
It's my home, David, paid for and in my name. You know the law, right?
Oh, I thought I knew a lot of things. Like when I'm out flanked.
Have a nice day.
Chloe, for once, just please shut up.
I hope Joyce doesn't hate me for tearing into David.
Eh, who cares?
Max, that gave me chills. And you better not rewind this one.
I won't.
Listen, when I went through David's laptop, I found pictures of Rachel and Frank being more than friends.
Right, no way, Max. She was just posing to tease Frank.
If you're not gonna believe me, why don't we check out what Frank has in his RV?
What's that gonna prove?
Frank has Rachel's bracelet. What else does he have in there?
Motherfucker better not have anything, for his sake. Let's check the door. Frank gets so wasted, he sometimes forgets to lock it.
I can't believe you hung out with him.
Not anymore. We have to be casual ninjas here. Shitballs. Okay, here's the plan. I'll go to the diner and distract Frank by telling him I have his money, but he needs to come with me. Then you come in and rewind so Frank doesn't see me. Then you can tell Frank he needs to check out his RV, and then you rewind after you get the key, and...
Chloe, I got this. I'll be right back.
Don't let my epic plan get in the way of yours. I'll try to scrounge up a Scooby snack to distract his mangy mutt.
Now to find a quick and easy way to snag Frank's keys. What is going on here?
Bird. Is someone playing golf? Looks like someone got a birdie. Help a hero. I'm gonna touch sooner. Oh, hey, Warren. By the way, the drive-in is actually popular, so I'm buying the tickets now. I'll let you take care of the popcorn in the other words. You can't back out now. Okay, let's go.
Good lord, bacon. I'm ready to nosh again. Ugh, but I need to get those keys from Frank.
You have serious balls, little girl. But hanging out with Chloe, playing with guns, and dressing up like Rachel doesn't make you cool or tough. What the fuck do you want? Take a picture of me and I'll break your fucking camera.
How do you know these are Rachel's clothes?
Because she looks beautiful in them and you look like ass. You're lucky I just took that gun from you.
Grab your keys and let's check out your RV.
Let's not. You fucking creep me out.
In other words, Max, no keys. Maybe I could chat up that officer, or even Nathan, and then go all Groundhog Day on them until I get the info I need.
Rachel! Whatever the fuck.
Oh, look, Max Amber. Nice outfit. By the way, thanks for getting me fucking expelled, you twee bitch. Lucky this is a public place.
Considering we're in a public diner with a police officer right over there, you shouldn't advertise your rage, Prescott.
Oh, yeah? You shouldn't have bitch snitched on me to that fucked up principal.
Listen, Nathan. I'll take back everything I said about you. If you hook me up with Frank. Know what I mean?
You look like you've never even taken a hit of baby aspirin.
How do you think I stay wired all night studying? So is it a deal or not?
Calm down, hard up. Deal. You'll get your school supplies, just go over to Frank and whisper, higher education. You'll hook your ass up.
Try interrogating somebody else, Lieutenant Caulfield.
Oops. Keep hitting the wrong one. Okay, I never talked to him. Okay, next part. He doesn't want to talk to me, I guess. Let's rewind to before I talk to him as well. Speak.
By the way, Frank, I was wondering if you had any, higher education.
Oh, yeah, sure. Do you want the after-school special to go with that? Jesus. Look, I don't sell anything but bottles to feed me and my dog. I work for a living, not like you spoiled Blackwell punks with too much time on your hands. But nothing. Don't ever ask me for anything ever again. Ever. And I'll back off. Get a new outfit. And leave me alone.
Keep it in the wrong one.
Damn, I really pissed him off. I need to go back.
There she is, Super Maxine. That's your new nickname around the bay. Sorry, but you did earn it. We're all real proud of you for helping Kate down.
Thanks, Officer Barry. I was just lucky. And right on time. Kate is who counts.
I'm glad you're representing Black Bull Academy.
I thought Nathan Prescott represents Blackwell.
Well, don't make me backwash this bacon. You know what the Prescotts represent.
Taking over Arcadia Bay?
You're not far wrong, Max. I heard the Prescotts are working on some new big land deals. Mr. Prescott helped out my family once a while ago. So I made a deal with him that I can't seem to get out of. Man, if I could get one instant replay in life. I better finish my breakfast first. There she is, Super Maxine. That's your...
Oh, it's Space.
New nickname.
Thanks, Officer Barry.
I'm glad you're...
Well, I heard a rumor you were working for the Prescott family on the side.
Jesus, doesn't this town ever shut up?
I don't blame you for getting extra work.
Look, sometimes I check up on the Prescott family to make sure they're doing all right. Nathan included. Keep this quiet, Max. There she is, Super Maxine.
Thanks.
I'm glad you're...
I feel like David Madsen represents Blackwell.
Not for long. He's a loose cannon. We all respect him for his service, but he's too eager.
He's eager to be a dick to me and Chloe.
That's true. He was ranting about a stolen gun, then I tuned out. Somebody's always out to get him. There she is, Supermax.
Thanks. Do you think Arcadia Bay is a weird town?
I'd take a normal city with normal problems about now. It makes me sick thinking about it.
Oops. Why do I keep on hitting that?
Rachel! What?
I heard your dad hired a local cop to keep an eye out on you and Frank Bowers. Like a babysitter.
Bullshit! My dad doesn't hire. He owns. And these pigs know better than to narc on me.
Do they? I hope that means Frank won't get busted.
Eventually, he will. Guy's into some freaky shit. He told me once he took a weird blood oath for Rachel. Forget I told you that. Seriously. Now get off my crack, whore. Keep your pie holes shut.
Seriously? Okay, I think that's the last thing. Now we talk to you about the blood oath.
You have serious balls, little girl. But hanging out...
David Mattson is looking for that gun. He might show up on your RV step.
Oh, I'm trembling. I don't need to take his little museum piece.
You know, there's some things I want to do first before we make any more progress.
I just wanted to see what would happen if I did this.
I'm gonna kill you.
You eat like a pig. Try the floor.
I was eating those beans. Are you fucking insane? I was eating those beans!
Okay. Enough being a dick to Frank. Let's make some progress. Wait. Why can't I mention the blood oath?
There she is.
Thanks.
Rachel!
Weren't you supposed to keep your mouth shut about the blood oath Frank took for Rachel?
Blood oath? Who? What the fuck? I never told anybody about that freaky shit. Besides, everybody knows Frank is a liar and a loser. Even Rachel did.
Yet Rachel Amber hung out with him more than you.
So, Rachel wanted Frank's stash. She let him take pictures, then he carries around her photo like she posed for love. Dumbass.
Now we rewind. And now we go up to Frank. This is really tedious. I think that's a word anyway.
What the fuck now?
You know I saw that photo Rachel gave you.
How do you know about that? Huh? Chloe, right?
She just told me that one of Rachel's favorite pictures was the one she did for you.
Really? Yeah, I mean, that's what I thought. She was just a natural beauty, you know? Wait, let me find it. Here, judge for yourself.
Take the keys?
I'm afraid I'll have to take your keys now, asshole.
You did not just do that. Give me back my keys, bitch. Give me my keys now!
Oops. Seriously? There you go.
Key brought. Now back to Chloe.
Now we can actually make some progress.
Kidding me?
Oh, let's help her.
Alyssa, watch out!
Quit thinking, Max.
There you go.
I should have known. The amazing Spider Max.
I couldn't have done it without Frank. Now let's get in and out.
You'll need this, Max. On your mark, get set, throw!
No, I'm not gonna throw it in the road. It's gonna get hit by a car if I do that.
Get the treat, treat boy!
I think we just made that dog our bitch. Get it?
Now we can snoop in peace, but let's not waste time. The doggy is busy now, but he might come back.
Damn, I thought my room was a shithole.
You're not a creepy drug dealer.
Frank has issues, but he's not creepy. At least I didn't think so until I saw him with Rachel's bracelet. Oh, we could cruise everywhere in this bad boy. Can you see us heading down the coast to Big Sur and beyond?
Yes, we'd be tearing up the highway. And you'd probably want me to kiss you again. Chloe, we're on a schedule. We need clues about Rachel.
I know. Just daydreaming.
Okay.
You scope the area while I hack his computer for info.
Good to know Frank has a knife lying around. Frank is almost a made-for-TV hoarder. This place is nasty. Okay, this vent is loose. I need something to pry it open. This is almost as good as a set of keys.
Yep. And more of a...
My blade will open any portal.
Portal blade joke. Take this.
Oh man, Rachel and Frank's dog. I don't know if I should be touched or disturbed.
Hope you read this first thing in the morning. Sorry about last night. I was being a monstrous bitch and took it out on you. And poor Pompidou, there's a lot of weird shit going on in my life, and sometimes I feel like I'm never going to get out of Arcadia Bay. Thank God for you. You're one of the best things I have here. And I smile when I think of how together. Let's just drive out of here forever. Love you always.
I'm glad Rachel got to drive this beast. She looks genuinely happy. Rachel really did hang out with Frank. I'm learning more about Rachel than I want to know. Trouble in paradise.
Frank, that was not cool with you, what you did. And don't blame the drugs. You actually scared me, and I thought you'd never chill out. I've never seen you act that way, and the next time will be the last. I'm a Leo, and we don't look back. I care about you, us. So maybe we need to break our routine. And of course, let's fix that.
Crappy Wi-Fi out here. Must take him days to download the porn.
It makes me ill that Rachel posed like this for Frank. I wrote him love letters. I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
Because she knew how you would react.
And she wasn't much of a friend, huh? Just another person who shits all over me. Why does everybody in my life let me down? My dad gets killed, you bail on me for years. My mother gloms on a stepfucker. Now Rachel betrays me.
Chloe, Rachel is missing. Nobody betrayed you.
Bullshit! Who hasn't? Fuck everybody! Chloe!
Chloe, you can't keep blaming me and everybody for everything wrong in your life. It's so not fair.
I gotta blame somebody, otherwise it's all my fault. Fuck that.
So now it's Rachel's fault too?
Jesus, she was banging that pig, Frank! Bitch lied to my face, Max! I can't trust anybody again. Everybody pretends to care until they don't. Even you.
Chloe Price, you better take that back. Right now.
Okay, fine. But you just don't understand. It's like I'm being punished by the universe.
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
You blame William? Really?
Yes, I do. Damn right. He chose to go out that door and leave me forever.
Chloe. Your dad didn't choose to leave you.
I know that, Max. My mom actually blames herself. Just because she wanted a ride home from work. Sometimes, even I blame her.
No, you don't.
Yes, Max, I do. Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? And he never does?
No, of course not. But I was with you that day. It was just a terrible accident.
I wish that made me feel better. But ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
You don't want to hear this, but you're still here, alive, with me. And that is no accident.
You're right. I don't want to hear this.
Chloe, I can't do this out on my own. I need you with me. And Rachel needs you.
Thank you.
Oh my god. What is happening now?
They say a picture speaks 1,000 words, so let's see how many words this picture speaks.
Time for a picture.
A, D keys. It must. This part is kind of tedious. Sorry about that.
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper.
Not until I see it first. You know the rules, Dad. Max, tell him.
Whoa, hey. You look totally pale. Are you okay?
Yeah. I just... Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, Chloe. Give me the thumbs up or thumbs down.
Well... I might just allow this one into the family album.
You're
the
boss. What is this?
But not the cook.
William is here.
Hint, Daddy.
Yes,
and
we can't.
Chloe is just a kid.
And serve us slackers.
Am I who that far back in time?
You mean pancakes?
In France, they call them crepes.
I'm 18 years old inside my 13-year-old self.
If you want to eat.
How?
We. I volunteer to break the eggs.
Do you remember how many eggs?
Mom said it depends.
That's true.
So, how many eggs?
Don't you dare question the chef.
Right, like you're the real cook here?
I am, when your mom is away.
I'll let her know that.
Oh, hey, is that... The picture looks like anime, if it's...
Hello?
Is it supposed to be anime?
Hey, honey. Just
yeah,
making a fabulous
so.
Breakfast with Chloe and Max. We're all going to work at the Two Whales. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Now I'll have an excuse to get a mocha. Be there shortly. Love you.
I have to stop William from taking his car today.
Ladies, I have to go rescue yonder queen at the Save Mart. She doth have many bags of delicious grub for us to feast upon.
You are ridiculous.
You'll be grateful
for that
someday.
Let's see where the keys are.
Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund. Keys, please. Aha!
Oh, I can't do it yet.
You can't hide from me forever. Now lock up after I leave. Play nice. Try not to destroy too much of the house. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
Oops. Seriously, I'm such an idiot. Okay, so let's rewind. Rewind more.
That's a dollar for the swear jar!
You mean your college fund?
Score!
Where are those keys?
Another dollar for the swear jar!
You're bankrupting me! I know I had those keys right here. I know it. Forgot all about you, little buddy. Release the keys! Of course. Last time I ordered from Spy Guy Electronics.
You can take the bus, right? The stop is right down the street.
This I can do. Good call, Max.
Oh yeah, the bus is great. It comes every 15 minutes and there'll be plenty of room for you and Joyce and groceries and it'll save the environment.
You sold me already. I'm off to yonder bus stop. Joyce will love this.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. You feel okay?
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Hello, are you even listening, Maxine?
All my friends in LA told me that Oregon was
Max.
Wet and cold every day.
But never, like Maxine.
So that's why she was laughing so much.
I know, sorry, Mad Max. You're not pissed at me, right? Right?
No, people in Oregon.
Do you want to go hit the girls' potty and smoke a peace pipe?
I think Max is high.
She's acting like so weird. You cool, Max?
Nobody listened when I said we shouldn't let her in the vortex.
Courtney, you don't want anybody in the club.
Like, whatever, bitch.
Warren, he hooked up with Stella?
Oh no, this is totally fucked up. What else have I changed? Chloe.
Yep. Everything is different.
Max Caulfield. Taking a break after taking Seattle by storm, huh? We thought we'd never see you again after you left for the big city.
No. I'd never do that to Chloe.
Speaking of, I know she's been dying to see you. Hold on. Chloe! You have a visitor!
So, that is all for this video, and I hope you enjoyed. So for this is going, I'd say well, but Chloe is kind of in a wheelchair. So, I'm not sure. This series is going well, though. In my opinion, that is. Okay, so. Bew. Thank you. Oh, you could have just skipped that. Yeah, sorry about that.